With me here in the studio, he's actually right here. I can touch him. I'll have to reach over a little bit, but I can touch him. Two-time Oscar winner, acting great. The one and only Mr. Denzel Washington, joined by, obviously, his director, Mr.
My co-conspirator,
Antoine Fuqua. Lovely to see you guys here. Can I just say, it's a real honor for me to be here with you. Antoine, I'm a big fan as well, obviously, the training day, and we will get to that at some stage. But how are you liking London just now?
Just got here last night, but, you know, I've been in London for the last almost 30 years, back and forth,
What about pub? Do you get to go to the pub and have a Guinness or something?
A proper Guinness.
Have you had a proper Guinness? You've been down to the Cow or any, like the pub? The Cow? I'm not saying people are going to find out. They're going to go down to the Cow. You've got to go down to the Cow and have a Guinness.
When I was here in the 80s working, I did for Queen and Country.
Yes.
But even before that, Cry Freedom, we worked a month here. When I would go to the airport, that was one of the last things. Because they always said it didn't travel.
No, it doesn't travel.
Right. Well, then the people in Ireland say it's no good here.
Well, it's getting better. Tell you where it's a good one. Nigeria now.
Nigeria?
They're doing a good Guinness now.
Oh, is that right?
And well, you know, at some stage, the brothers will get in there and start to do things better than the Irish. Like my friend there, he's an Irishman, and like he,
never
he's
happened.
Got something to say. It will never happen. Guys,
we've
got to talk about the Equalizer. I saw it yesterday.
Right.
I love it, man.
Thank you.
You know what I mean? As much as I love Denzel just in the main, but that character, if I wanted to play a character, that would be the character Antoine. Right. Have you seen the film, like the Equalizer? Did you have to see that film to get into that character?
It's a process. You know, what's good about it and what Antoine did with it and what we did when we were shooting was we took the time to develop. You get to know the guy. And you're like, oh, he's not some superhero. He's sort of got weird.
He's got some OCD thing.
He's alone, and he goes to the diner at 2 a.m. to read. So he's
with his tea bag.
With his tea bag, well folded.
That's what I was gonna say with his book, with his 91st book as well. Have you got anything like OCD? Where'd you get the tea bag in the?
That's from Denzel.
Wow. Yeah.
Well, the script gave us a hint, which is why does he keep checking his watch for all kinds of stuff, which led me to doing research about the OCD behavior and which made me say, okay, maybe what happened in his past has made him turn into this. And he has a good heart. He's trying to help people. He tries to help the kid lose weight. He's trying to talk to the girl, but... Yeah, you know that he's not perfect. You know he's got issues of some sort, and he meets this... other lost soul, this little 15-year-old girl.
Yeah, which we see, which kind of tips him over.
Right,
but you know,
exactly.
I tell you, there's a bit in the film where, honestly, Antoine, I love the bit in the film where he sits across with the bad guy and, you know, he raps down this dialogue of what the bad guy was about. Right. I want to know what Robert, what Bob, what McCall is about. I want to know how did he get there?
Right.
And then there's a bit in the film, Antoine, where he goes to this lady who's got a helicopter in it. She goes to find out
something. Melissa Leo,
At some stage, we got to find out how he got to that, McCall got to that level.
Hey, if the audience goes, you'll see.
right.
It's all up to the audience. If they go, they'll see.
It's fantastic. As well, you know what I like as well? The first scene, I can't give too much away because I was in there and I was all like...
Oh, you mean when he's up in the office?
When I watched it yesterday,
when he went
in the office.
Because
I'm thinking, okay, he's gone in the office, he's going to try and do his stuff. But then what happens is that he gets ready to leave.
Right.
But there's five of them. Right. I don't like gruesomeness in the main because I'm quite a wimpy in that way. But when it's against bad guys for some reason, I kind of liked it. And who comes up with the idea? Like, for instance, the shot glass, the corkscrew.
How much of that was in the script and how much did you get? You guys added all it.
Yeah.
Antoine is sick. He's a very sick man.
Hey, let me tell you something.
He would walk around at home, Mart. He just... I'd go in his office and it'd be more weapons of destruction. I mean, it's like, what do you got in there? He's like, we're going to use these. I'm like, what?
Can I say, because
the trainer...
We've got to let people know, because my man here, I brought my best mate here because he loves you, Denzel. He loves Training Day. Now, Training Day is a character. That character as Denzel... He took me somewhere, man, because I love Denzel.
Yeah.
And that character, he was so dark and so...
Sociopath.
Honestly. You know, sick, and you know, so how'd you come up with it? Why'd you get a character like that from, Antoine?
Well, me and Denzel talked a lot about the script. It wasn't in the script like that, for sure.
What was he going to be just...
In the script, he had on like a Tommy Bahama shirt on. And
beer cans in the back.
And me and Dee sat down with some people we know that were undercover cops of the... little savory type, you know, and we sat down and had a little dinner with them and talked to them, and we
started just getting ideas.
But these cats look like and act like gangsters,
right?
the Russians as well. There's a Russian aspect in training there as well. There's a Russian aspect in there. Mm. Crazy people. Mm. So I didn't mind seeing them get like done over like they did.
Yeah. Get done over. You know,
they got done over. They got,
I like
they
that.
Got
they
got
done over.
Done over. They got sorted.
They got sorted.
Are we gonna, we've got to find out because, you know, he does his 16 seconds, 18 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're going to find out what that's all about at some stage.
You're lobbying for the sequel here, right? Dang, we got to take you on tour with us.
Yeah, really. Yeah.
The thing about it is that, I get excited anyway, but I love films.
Mm.
But the fact is that I don't like the violence in it for no reason. But like I said, there's something about bad guys getting dealt with where they've pushed people to a point where, right, something's got to be done. It's got to be done so people get the message like bad guys do.
Right.
And that... is what McCall done. But Des as well, it's just the human side of him with, like I say, with Ralphie.
Yeah, yeah.
So how's it going to pan out? Because we just...
Don't know.
Yeah,
and I think what you're saying is what people feel. They, you know, not to say the way the world is today, but people do feel powerless.
Mm.
It's like, yeah, okay, yeah, go get them.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, I'll watch this.
Because people, in the main... We've seen like that guy as well, Denzel, with his fisherman clothes kind of. Like, I've got to say, his old man fisherman kind of clothes.
He didn't keep any of those clothes, by the way. Yes,
with his fisherman clothes. I got to use that.
With, you know, plaids and big trousers. Yeah. And, you know, but the thing is, because it works, because you think to yourself, he's somebody that, you know, young people. Yeah. Most probably disrespect someone like that until they look at your face.
Well, you know what? What years of training... Being in the gym, seeing mixed martial artists, jiu-jitsu masters, and this and that, leave people alone because you don't know.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. You don't know. And you never saw, I mean, it was, the clothes were frumpy, and I liked that.
Yeah.
I was like, that's what I want. You know, that he shouldn't be slick. He shouldn't be Miami Vice.
Yeah. No,
he's just an older guy and he's trying to blend in.
Well, it's like we got the two young guys who are saying, come on, man.
Yeah, yeah.
What did you do? What did you do before?
Right,
and then you've done
the night. Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's the kind of thing, because you're so blended in.
Right.
You know,
right.
With the boxing, I know you're a boxing fan as well. You know what I mean? Because obviously the Hurricane,
right.
You know, he died not too long ago. God rest his soul. Yeah. And that brought everything to everybody's consciousness about what happened with him, which was fantastic. Yeah. But boxing. Are you a boxing fan?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
A massive boxing fan.
Yeah, yeah.
And the fight sequences.
I was with Lennox Lewis a couple of times.
Yeah?
Yeah, when he fought Shannon Briggs, we all went out. And then when he beat up on Mike Tyson, we were all together. Yeah, yeah.
And I got to talk about...
What's Lennox Lewis doing now?
Well, Lennox is just like chilling, man, with his big self.
Right.
You know?
Has he gotten Lennox big?
Well, he's just a big guy.
Yeah, he's big boy.
It's like Serena, man. They're just big people.
He's huge.
He's huge. Yeah. But he's just a big person.
He earned the right.
Yeah, absolutely. But you know, he's one of those as well where he's a calm, cool guy.
Right.
He's a calm, cool guy. I just wanted to say just quickly, because we're gonna have to leave, because people are starting to do that arm thing.
Okay.
But I'm trying to look like
act like you don't see me.
Because I'm here.
That's right.
I've got the ball. We gotta ask you, Tone, because we always say, Antoine, who came up with the line at Training Day? Okay, whoa. Let me quarterback this thing. Where did that come from? That
might have been in the script.
I didn't
ad-lib that.
Was that one from
Remember, I wouldn't come up with quarterback this. Did I?
Did,
I ad-libbed a lot.
Did you ad-lib?
Yeah.
Was a blinding.
King Kong, all of that was.
I think you did.
That was a blinding bit.
Yeah. Hey, let me quarterback this thing.
Let me quarterback.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because you were talking to Paul and those cats.
See, I might have got it from them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because these cops were throwing all kinds of, I'm like, how do you stay alive? Mm. He said, informants. He said, the people on the street don't know who's working for me.
Mm.
So that keeps them all. That's why I come up to a group of them and I say, hey, you better call me and just walk away.
Yeah.
And they're like, call you? What do you mean? You know him?
Yeah, now he's got a problem.
Yeah, okay. Now that guy's got a problem.
Say, that's a good way to do it. Listen, did you get, just finally, because we do a football show, so with soccer? And do you know about the soccer and how he's kicking off in America now?
Yeah, and what's the kid? Well, not from England, from Italy. The African kid. What's his name?
Balotelli.
I've been hearing a lot about him in the States.
Well,
you don't want to hear about that, right? Because he played for Italy.
The thing with Balotelli, because he's got an infamy as well, because he's got a dark side.
Mm.
He's somebody,
really?
He's somebody, Antoine. You need to check him out because I think that he's got films in him.
Yeah.
Balotelli's got films in him.
Yeah.
All right.
You know what I mean?
But he's like an orphan or something, right?
Yeah, he's
an orphan. Yeah, from Ghana or from somewhere.
Yeah, an African and Italians took him in. He's a fantastic footballer, but...
You know, he's got a dog
He's got training day issue kind of.
Really?
Training day guy issue.
You see, you never know.
You'd never know. Listen, guys, I don't want to hold you up on our business, hey, but can I just say, thanks very much for the time.
To my boy, Kel Brooks.
Kel Brooks, yeah.
That's my man. Yeah, I just let him know I'm in town, try to hook up with him.
Nice. He's a player? He plays?
He's a boxer.
He's a boxer,
oh, yeah?
Man.
Kel Brooks.
Just won the world title.
But it was Kel, was what, 148?
Yeah.
Yeah, he can fight, yeah.
Oh, yeah?
But he had a problem the other day in Spain, you know what I mean?
What?
He got stabbed in the leg in Spain.
Why?
Yeah, some people, he was out there with his family and stuff.
With his dad and everybody?
Yeah. So you need to hook him up if you're going to...
Is he undefeated?
Yeah.
So what, Mayweather don't want to see him?
No, it's Amir Khan. Him and Amir Khan now have got a big fight over
here. Well, maybe.
Him and Mayweather, hey, it'd be a fight. He's a bad boy.
He's a bad boy. He's not as bad as McCall.
Has Mayweather fought? I mean, has this kid, what's his name?
Kel.
Has he fought anybody?
Well, he's now getting to that level, Denzel, where he's got to start fighting people.
We'll
I think he's going to
be
20. He's going
to have to. Better wear his big boy pants.
He's going to have to. He's going to have to.
He's going to have to.
But he's quick and he's a bad boy. Yeah.
He's knocking folks out?
Nah, he's beating them down, D. Beating them down.
Listen, guys, again, Denzel Washington, Antoine Fuqua, thank you very much for your time. This film is awesome. I can't wait for the sequel.
There it is.
If there's anything, done if the role is, if there's any kind of little English part I could be.
You got
I'm
it.
Only joking.
Done.
I'm only joking. Antoine,
man.
Denzel.
My pleasure.
My man.
Bless you, bro. Nice one.